Whatever you do, emails are not going anywhere. We can minimize them and we can manage them more efficiently. And that's what we will see today. I'm going to give you two things. First, a lot of ideas which you can use. And second, a custom toolbar which I have developed over a period of time and I find it really useful. So let's get started. Emails have a lot of text and it is boring. How do you make it more interesting? We don't want to do manual formatting, so we use automatic formatting, which is called styles. Go to the styles, choose heading 1, 2 or 3. These are the shortcuts. In fact, I have put the button in the custom toolbar as well. Now that we have styles, we can create a table of contents. Insert a link at the beginning, place in the document and link it to the different topics. So even long mails are easy to read. Sometimes we may want to refer to a specific line. That also is possible. Insert a bookmark and again link it to the table of contents. Very useful. Many times, we open an old mail and copy-paste some part of it in a new mail. That's a bad idea. If you think you are writing something and I may need it tomorrow also, just select it, go to Insert Quick Part and add it to that gallery. So next time, in one click, you get all your quick parts. No need to open another mail or another document. Have you made a list anytime, bullets or numbering? Stop doing that, because the moment you put bullets or number, there are multiple items and most probably people are going to respond to all those items. How are they going to do that? By pressing enter after every bullet. Stop doing it and think, can I make it a table? The same thing you put in the first column of the table and then you put extra columns. Now when you send the mail to other people, they can actually put their responses in that extra column. It is much more convenient for you and everyone else to correlate who is saying what. Even if you get multiple replies with multiple tables, it's still better than copy-pasting too many paragraphs. Now, tables are good, but there is something even better if you are going to send the mail to people only within your organization. You go to Insert Loop Component and there is a table there as well. What's the benefit of this table? It's still a table, rows, columns, you decide. When I send the table, people don't have to reply at all. That's the best part. They can actually edit the table there itself and everyone gets updated. Simple and effective. So mails often have files attached to them. Now files are a problem. Well, there are two types of files. One is where you send the file and forget. So it could be a brochure, it could be an invitation for an event that is not coming back. Those kind of files you attach. But if there is a file, you're sending it to people and you expect them to do some changes and get it back, then do not send attachments. Please send links. The files which are on cloud, whether OneDrive, Teams, whatever, they will have a cloud icon. When you click that, it'll actually suggest that you should send it as a link. Please do that, because when you send an attachment, you absolutely lose control. Yes, you may get the file back, but 5 people send a file, you copy-paste, 2-3 more rounds, 27 copies floating around, everyone's work is increasing and clarity is decreasing. So it's absolutely inefficient. Instead of that, send a link. The file doesn't go anywhere. People come to the file. All changes are merged automatically. Single copy, not a single copy-paste. That's called efficient. In fact, I am going to create a separate video for that as well. You may not have noticed, but the dictate option has become very powerful nowadays. It does require an internet connection, but the accuracy is phenomenal. So click on the dictate button, choose the best mic you have, and choose the correct language, and just talk. Based on our discussion, I feel the following content will be relevant. New line, we are going to cover Excel and Power BI. New line, the main topic include, delete that. In fact, click on the help button. You'll be surprised as to how many commands it can understand. I'm sure you'll love the dictate feature. In fact, I'm sure you'll love the video as well, so might as well subscribe and like. Now, whatever we have discussed so far, I've actually put it in practice and created a custom toolbar. All the buttons which are relevant are grouped, and then you can add this custom toolbar to your Outlook. How do you do that? Details are in the description. Oh, wait. We are not done yet. Before you send the mail, look at the top and you will see some very useful mail tips. Example, I am about to send a mail to someone who is out of office. Isn't it better to know it before you send it? Second, I am about to send a mail to someone whose mailbox is full. It's not going to reach there. So before mistakes happen, they can be prevented. You just have to look at the mail tips and take action. And a bonus tip. Think of others. Whenever we are sending mails, we are thinking of ourselves and are getting our job done. Agreed. But think, am I sending a mail to someone who is currently in a different time zone? It's not their working day. We never think about that. You don't have to. There is a delay delivery option. In fact, there are two delay delivery options. One is the old one, one is the new one. Old way, you go to the options tab and say delay delivery and then choose a different date and time. But remember, your Outlook has to be open at that time for it to work. So not very practical. But a better, newer, modern option is with Office 365. I am about to send a mail to someone, but currently it is my working time, that person is not working. It will actually show you the option saying, do you want to delay the delivery? And it will suggest the correct time where that person can receive the mail. So you send it now, your Outlook doesn't need to be open, and it will be delivered at the right time to the other party. Best of both worlds. I am sure you have liked this, so like the video as well. Subscribe, click the bell icon, and most importantly, share it with all your colleagues, because mails cannot be effectively managed alone. Other parties are involved. Most important, if I miss something or if you have a question about what I have said, do put it in comments. I'll be happy to answer you. So that's it for now. Thank you.